So project stakeholder management includes the process required to identify the people, group or organization that could impact or be impacted by the project, to analyze stakeholder expectation and their impact on the project, and to develop appropriate management strategies for effectively engaging stakeholder in project decision and execution. Stakeholder satisfaction should be managed as a key project objective. Now, to identify project people, group or organization that could impact or be impacted by a decision, activity or outcome is identification of stakeholder. So what is the tools and what is the inputs? Project charter, documents, procurement document, enterprise, EF and OPS. Tools and techniques is stakeholder analysis, expert judgment and meetings, and what we get out of this is a stakeholder register. So we need to create a stakeholder register as a document for every project. So that will have names of all the people. Now remember one thing, when we are looking at a stakeholder identification, we don't identify stakeholder just by designations. Stakeholder identification should be in terms of the actual name of the person. Now once we identify the stakeholders, what we need to do is analyze the stakeholder. What do we analyze? We look at the levels of interest and influence the stakeholder has, or the level of power and impact the stakeholder has, or the legitimacy of the stakeholders. And what we do is we create a power interest grid. So on one side is the power, on one side is the interest. So at the conjunction we have the low, and on the other side is the high. So you, all those people who falls in the high interest, high power, they are the people who needs to be managed closely. That means that you as a project manager need to talk to them every day, because they have the highest interest in the project and they have the highest power, so they can create the biggest problem for you if they are not satisfied. So you need to be absolutely in touch with them on a regular basis to understand how they are feeling about the project and to inform them on how the project is progressing. See, one of the things we need to understand is we as human beings, we don't like surprises, and we do not want to be kept in dark. Let's say for example, if you are creating a, let's say you have got an interior designer to do a, your apartment. Now the interior designer comes, shows you all the 2D and 3D diagrams and all, and you approve it, you sign on that, and you say that this is the budget, etc., etc., and you approve that, and then the person goes. Now after 8 months they come and tell you that okay, your house is ready or the apartment is ready, please come and see. How will you feel? Will you like that way to things to happen? Obviously you will not like things to happen that way. You would like to see how things are progressing on a regular basis. So you need to make sure that the stakeholders who is the most important, who has the highest interest and highest power, are always kept in touch on a daily basis. Person who has high power but low interest, keep them satisfied because of the point that they have high power. They can create problems for you if they are not satisfied. They might not have a lot of interest in the project. They may be least bothered about how project is proceeding, but keep them satisfied. Then you have some people who have high interest but low power. you need to keep them informed. The reason you need to keep them informed is they may be able to influence the high power people. And finally, you have the low power, low interest people. You do not need to spend much time on them. Just make sure that you are monitoring their movement. That means sometimes these people might go into the other three quadrants. Today, who is having low power and low interest might suddenly become high power and high interest. For example, today let's say there is a manager who is not powerful and neither is interested in the project because of his role in the organization. But his boss is the person who is the project sponsor, let's say. Obviously, the sponsor will be the highest interest, highest power. Now, suppose the sponsor is transferred to a different department or to a different geography, and this manager is promoted to his place to take up that responsibility. What happens then? This guy who was a low interest, low power guy now has become a high power, high interest person because he has become the sponsor for you. So you need to constantly keep track of such people to see that they are in their position and not move to any other quadrant. And accordingly, if they move, you have to change your approach to that person. Now, one of the reasons why this is done is because project manager has to interact with so many people, it is not possible to look at each and every activity. Similarly, he cannot meet each and every person every day of life to discuss things. So he has to prioritize his timings, and these are ways of prioritizing his timings. Once this analysis is done, then you go into planning the stakeholder management. So you develop an appropriate management strategy to effectively engage stakeholders throughout the project life cycle based on the analysis of their needs, interest and potential impact on project success. So project management plan, stakeholder register, EF and OP are your input, expert judgment, meeting and analytical techniques are your tools, output is your project document update and stakeholder management plan. Now, if you look at it, there are different analytical techniques. The current engagement level of all stakeholders, it can be classified as follows. So some stakeholder may be completely unaware that such a project is happening. Now, it is your responsibility. If the person is a stakeholder, that means is getting affected or can affect, you need to make sure that that person is aware of the project, because if they are not aware now itself at the beginning, they come to know of things later on and they may come up with new requirements or may put a spanner in your progress. May even, if they are powerful enough, may even stop the project. So you have to, when you are doing the requirements gathering, when you have initially identified the stakeholders, from that time onwards, you have to keep an eye open for all these and make sure that gradually you identify all such unaware people and inform them. Then there will be some people who are resistant. Now what you need to do is you have to make sure that the people who are resistant, even if you cannot make them supportive, try and make them neutral. Similarly, people who are neutral is the most dangerous. They can go anywhere. Now this set of people, you have to make sure that you keep them either neutral or make them tilted towards supportive and should not go towards resistant. See, one of the things what happens is if a manager, let's say, is resistant and there is a manager who is neutral, but the neutral guy and the resistant guy are both friends or goes to lunch together on a regular basis, there is high probability that this neutral guy will also move towards the to becoming resistant. So you need to keep them informed keep that person satisfied so that instead of this neutral guy becoming resistant, he can influence the resistant guy to become at least neutral. Similarly, supportive guy, you have to make sure that he continues to be supportive and then or move, become leading. And leading is the guy who will evangelize your project, your progress, who will go in the customer organization and say that you are doing a great job, who will say that the project is going great. So that is the guy who you should be always be supporting. So stakeholder management plan will have desired and current engagement level of stakeholders, scope and impact of change to stakeholders, identified relationships, interrelationships and potential overlap between stakeholders, communication requirement, information to be distributed to stakeholders, time frame and frequency, refining the stakeholder management. So after you plan, you actually do manage stakeholder engagement. Again, the tools and techniques that you have is communication methods, interpersonal skill and management skill. And what you get is the issue log, output, change request, project management plan update, document update and OPA updates. So to communicate and work with stakeholders to meet their need, expectation, address issues as they occur and foster appropriate stakeholder engagement in project activities throughout the project life cycle is the objective of managed stakeholder engagement. Now communication methods. The communication method is all defined in the communication plan. So based on your analysis of the stakeholder at the stakeholder management level, you actually use this as an input to define your communication plan. What are the type of interpersonal skills that is required? You need to build trust. You need your stakeholders to have trust on you. You have to resolve conflicts. Even with your customer, you need to be a good active listener. You will see some people who doesn't listen well. When the customer is trying to say something, that person is busy trying to explain what he feels should be. Now that is not the right way of doing things. You should give or a good listen ear to listening what the stakeholders say. Understand that, make sure that you evaluate it properly before you respond. And overcoming resistance to change. Now resistance to change again is a basic feature of a human being. We all are averse to change. We are always resistant to change, even for ourselves. How many times, how many of us are open enough to decide to change our jobs frequently? When we think of changing the jobs, until and unless it is a, we really find it difficult, we don't change. Okay, again we have to go and we have to establish ourselves in a new organization. My current colleagues and friends will be lost, then again I have to create new friends and colleagues. So we keep thinking of all those things. So in our life also we are resistant to change. The same thing is applicable for others. So change management actually is a very important aspect, organizational change management, for any implementation. So you as a project manager need to make sure that you help in overcoming those resistances. What are the management skills that is required? Management skills that are required are presentation skills, because you have to present to your stakeholders. Negotiation skills. Customer will say you have to work on the, over the weekend and you have to deliver something on Monday. You have already planned for a vacation and the customer knew about it. It is a very difficult task to say no to customer. We always keep saying yes, yes, yes to everything, but that is not the right thing. If you have already planned and if it was conveyed and if it is planned, you need to carry on with your plan. But at the same time, you need to understand what is the requirement, why the customer needs, negotiate with him and see what is the best solution that you can give. The idea is to provide a solution to the customer. But what happens is, invariably we get into an ego kind of a situation and we try to satisfy the ego. You need to have good writing skills, putting formal documentation of all the things so that you are not in trouble later on. You have documented evidence of everything that you have done. And obviously public speaking is one of the important management skills that is required. And then you have to control stakeholder engagement, making sure that everything is moving fine as per your stakeholder management plan. So information management system, expert judgment and meetings are your tools and techniques. Work performance information, change request, project management plan update, project document update and OPA update are your outputs. Implementation of which process decreases the risk of project failure? The answer is A, manage stakeholder engagement. By properly managing stakeholder, you will reduce the risk of project failure. Planning is one of the activities. The five levels of stakeholder engagement are obvious, opposed, neutral, proactive, driving, unaware, opposed, neutral, supportive, driving, oblivious, resistant, neutral, supportive, leading, unaware, resistant, neutral, supportive, leading. Yes to the answer is D, unaware, resistant, neutral, supportive and leading. Plan stakeholder management is fundamentally concerned with all the following except developing strategies to effectively engage stakeholder throughout the project, development of the stakeholder register, development of the stakeholder management plan, identifying how the project will affect stakeholders. Couple of you have said D. That is definitely not the right answer. Because identifying how the project will affect stakeholders is also important. It is not only how stakeholders will affect the project, but also how stakeholders will be affected. You need to take care of it. That's not an issue. I mean, that's definitely is part. What is not part? Yes, the answer is B, development of the stakeholder register. Stakeholder management starts after identifying the stakeholder. Your register is created when you are identifying the stakeholder. It is only after you identify and do the analysis that you get in, then you get into the management of stakeholders. You cannot manage without identifying the stakeholder itself and analyzing the stakeholder. So you don't need to remember like by heart, but you need to understand the concept. And if you have not identified the stakeholder, if you have not done that analysis that what is their interest and impact, what is their power and interest, if that is not done, how will you plan how you need to interact with those stakeholders? So identification and creating that stakeholder register is much earlier than stakeholder management. You are engaged in gathering information from stakeholder regarding whose interests should be taken into account throughout the project. This is called identify stakeholders, stakeholder analysis, expert judgment, plan stakeholder management. 4 is B, stakeholder analysis. Which of the following is not included in stakeholder management plan? project life cycle communication requirement, impact of scope changes to stakeholders, stakeholder management strategy. This was easy. 5 is A, project life cycle has nothing to do with stakeholder management. Most projects will have a dash number of stakeholders, resistant, supportive, diverse, unknown. Yes, it is C, diverse. Which of the following is not an input to control stakeholder engagement process? Project management plan, issue log, project documents, work performance information. Yes, 7, the answer is D, work performance information. Work performance information has nothing to do with controlling stakeholder engagement. The ability of stakeholder to influence the project is typically highest at the following stages: planning, initial, execution, design. Ability of the stakeholder to influence the project is typically highest at the dash stage. And the answer here is B, initiation. Remember that graph that we had seen earlier. At the initiation stage is when it is higher. That is the time when you are doing initiating. Initial stage it is higher. Planning is your own activity. Planning is project manager's activity, where there is not much of, even though, and number two is planning is not only at the initial stage, planning spreads across a period of time. Over a period of time you do planning. So it is at the initial stage that when the project stakeholders influence is highest. The three I's of stakeholders are independence, influence and inquiry, importance, inquiry and influence, interest, influence and importance, influence, inquiry and importance. 9 is C, interest, influence and importance. So how much interest they have, how the stakeholder has on the project, how much influence they have over the project, and how important is this project to them. These are the three factors which actually determines how you should interact with such stakeholders. So a stakeholder is anyone who is involved in the project, anyone positively or negatively impacted by the project, anyone who can influence the direction of the project, anyone who can impact or be impacted proactively, positively or negatively by the project. 10, yes, the answer is D.